Oh, hello, back again. I'm gonna make my last and final. Really, my opinion from Bibi. Really, it's just how much surviving more of this. So, and also there's like no. I say, there's no buzz, no hype for this game at all. Notice now the. You go on the forum of the Crust, basically. I mean, there are like 10 posts that are active. Every several hours, someone posts something, but that's about it. Which means there is no hype for this game, no interest in this game. And yeah, it's because it's like surviving Mars with a couple of elements from Satisfactory or Factorio, I guess. But somehow made worse. So I'm gonna show you. In Surviving Mars, how you start? Well, what? By having a rocket. First rocket to land somewhere on the planet. In case you have the ready. This is the story mode. I'm gonna finish the story mode in the demo if I crash. And step by step. I give you the equivalent Surviving Mars. So you start with a couple of bots, resources, with a delivery. There's a cargo pod. Because Moon has lower gravity, can have pods. This higher gravity. No, quite low gravity still, but not higher than. Anyway, so you start. What do you do? Build solar panels. Guess what you need to build at first. What do you need to build first in Mars? Well, do you need solar panels or windmills? Again, there is no atmosphere at all on the moon. So that's not gonna work. By the way, I'm kind of wondering how the fuel generator is going to work. Because oxygen, very, I don't know. Anyway, power is up. I did a try this day. I moved a lot of things.
Director, he's correct. A lunar night lasts nearly 14 and a half Earth days in the absence of sunlight, and batteries are crucial for us. Construct 4 batteries next to the solar panels.
Objective achieved.
Your drones did it. Next.
Go to the communications.
Then building that just make which the drone switch from one to another. Surviving Mars, you don't have this. Drones, they do everything. This is just another an app. It's just because of the voxel mining, I guess. So you can very change.
Now, let's have the drones excavate, and to order the drones to start the excavation, for mining, and the digging drones will do the rest. Robert, to answer your question, our company has been providing repair and maintenance services for robotics and mining equipment for over 10 years. We were involved in the development and maintenance of technology for lunar mining along with the first industrial expeditions to the moon, even before the construction of the space elevator and the full-scale development of the moon by mankind. And I'm pleased to inform you, Robert, that by accumulating our vast experience, we have been able to develop and implement multifunctional drone technology that can be re-equipped for a variety of tasks. As a special...
Okay, Director.
We're all still on the...
So what's up with the...
Something happened. He crashed. Oh.
Robert, come in, Robert. Do you read me? According to the data, there are no survivors on the base, but I had to check. And I shouldn't have said anything about flowers. We're still receiving a signal from the drones. Our best bet is to try to repair the lift and rebuild the power supply circuit in order to save our equipment. It seems we have no other choice. We are in urgent need of solar panels and accumulators connected in one electrical circuit. With the available resources, direct the drones to construct the power supply modules, aiming to restore the previous setup prior to the explosion. Remember to connect the modules with wires.
Based on the spread of the blast wave, it appears that the explosion took place on the far side of the moon. Fortunately, it occurred at a considerable distance from our mission. However, the strength of the explosion raises additional questions.
So, the only response we get from the head of the scientific department and a renowned scientist is that the explosion was far away, and we don't know the cause?
That's because scientists rely on established facts rather than speculating based on unreliable data. They prefer to work with what is known rather than jumping to hasty conclusions. I've heard that First Vice President Alice Vance maintains her composure and professionalism in all circumstances. Perhaps it's time for you to call your alter ego.
Maybe I should, Professor. Tell me, prior to the moon launch, we were actively involved in a range of technologies aimed at advancing autonomous mining. Could you provide an update on the status of this project?
We had a plan for an autonomous extraction plant, but it's currently just a project. Given the circumstances, implementation seems unlikely.
Now we need to fix the elevator to regain access to the underground level. Select it and order the drones to start repairing it. You can change the game speed.
I'll watch this.
Objective achieved.
Director, Crust have made an official statement.
On this day, as a result, we want...
Objective achieved.
So, it turned out to be a
collision of an asteroid. Anyway, we've
While Lunar Outpost, now we do start by researching and building the pressing module, which enables the production of smart concrete from regolith. Professor Wilfrey will explain to you how to use our research projects, and I will come back to you later.
Let's begin with the fundamentals, Director. Each unit of Regolith contains its own percentage of valuable resources, and at the moment, you're primarily mining barren rock. To locate resource deposits, we require the ore detector. Open the research panel, select geological exploration, and we can proceed with our work. Once this research is completed, you'll gain the ability to construct the ore detector. We had prepared this research plan for the distant future, but we must adapt and work with it now. It may seem cynical, but considering the circumstances, our best course of action at the moment is to try to save the equipment that has miraculously survived. All right, now get the drones to build it. I wouldn't wait too long if I were you. And add a bulk resource storage to it, so your drones have a place to take the regolith they've mined. Keep in mind that the detector contains ultra-sensitive phased arrays, making it essential to construct it below the moon's surface. It is not designed to withstand lunar dust and solar radiation. Wire it up. The ore detector uses battery power to every scan. The bigger the scanning area, the more power it requires. Select the ore detector and scan the regolith around it. You need to find the nearest iron vein and then excavate the regolith from it with mining drones.
Objective achieved.
Using the detector consumes battery power, and the larger the scan area, the more power is consumed. Remember this and try not to leave your base without power. Now, we require a smelting furnace which employs the reduction method to convert the oxide into usable resources. Although we haven't tested this technology yet, theoretically it should work as intended.
Theoretically? Professor, are you sure that it's worth taking the risk at this moment?
Our whole enterprise is now one big risk. It can't be eliminated even if we do absolutely nothing. So yes, I'm quite certain about that. Now select the recipe for producing steel in the smelting furnace. The smelting furnace always requires oxides to begin production of any resource, and mining drones are able to extract oxides directly from the vein. It's not the most efficient way, but we have to start right now. Order them to excavate the regolith on top, and then assign them to extract iron oxide from the vein. Enter excavation mode to be able to assign mining. Now you have steel and smart concrete production, but it is extremely inefficient. To secure...
You do have a plan.
And while they're digging, we need to research underground mining and build the extractor. Select the necessary research, and we will start working on it.
Here starts one of the problems. To build an extractor, cannot be transformed. You will only go to the extractor here. Worthless about this research here. Because only the refinery can actually use the regolith that gets produced from. It's very silly. But hey. Tell me to build a reactor. First of all, Don't need any miners anymore. Everybody's a transporter now.
Water building. Make sure to connect the extractor to the circuit by. The shift button will help you to create a chain of electric poles. I assume the extractor has started mining operations. Now let's research the single regolith.
They are actually aware of it. Just makes no sense.
Prior to the expedition, we devised a three-stage. The first one, the second stage.
Absolutely no sense to have this. It would make sense if you can put the extractor anywhere and they extract just regolith concrete, but you cannot. So it's really. Not very efficient. No. Oh, whatever. That's gonna finish.
A single regolith refinery, according to its name, can only get one type of oxide at a time. Be sure to select the iron oxide recipe to start production.
And now that you have a functioning steel production...
Director, unauthorized signal on line one. I think you might want to hear this. I'm putting it on the main screen.
Ratchet, did you hear the news? Crust put you in charge.
Not only have we... Anyway, direct...
Wait a second, so there is nothing bothering you two? What makes you think we're even accepting this offer, and how about checking with me and the director?
Alice, back to 15 years ago, Wilfrey and I were working for Crust. I was dusting off the first lunar rovers, and he was hanging out in the lab. Crust holds significant authority, having constructed the space elevator and maintaining control over all the moon. If Crust says they will work with us, I'm afraid we have no choice.
Given the circumstances, it's actually in our favor.
The situation...
If there were any discernible advantage...
Wilfrey is indeed an aging... Crust gave us the coordinates of the repeater near... Before the explosion...
Now that we have...
Great, Wilfrey...
It's a remote...
It is still, it still scratches an itch that I've, there's some hope for it. Not like hitting it. I think it's very good.
You now have the capability to construct production chains. At this point, I'll hand you over to Ratchet and Alice. If things continue progressing like this, we might just have a chance to succeed.
Could anyone deny having more satisfaction? Very fast, that is very satisfactory. Miner, the smelter, is it the mining, or the, that's called the extractor, miner, same thing. Then here it goes into refining. Because it mines anything, but just a smelter, basically. Basically, they put these two, these two are smelters. They make one and two. Then they took the smelter and put it in two different. Make sure that we get right comfortably. I mean, even if without electricity, we have no humans, we only bots, so first thing down. Bots will. If they don't have anything to put, they just don't move and probably don't. It's a little bit the problem I have so far with the game is that there is no real urgency. In Surviving Mars, you had to advance at some at a certain pace because you needed certain goods to maintain your stuff. Here, so far, all you need is steel, which is the easiest thing to do. is steel and concrete. Anything more complicated? There's nothing more complicated so far.
So what's the next plan? Reinvest the super profits into buying the real estate when there's blood in the streets? Director, the Earth needs resources now, but that's no reason to profit from tragedy. And even if we were going to do this, how do we reach the Earth? The explosion disrupted all the logistics.
Mr. Ledger has already contacted.
He even went behind our back.
Well, Director.
Director.
Gonna research every. We have so much electricity. It repairs once more.
We're done here. Resources are on their way to the base. It's time to report back to Crust. Scouting, as usual. Send the rover to the cargo terminal coordinates to see what's left of it and what we can do about it.
achieved. Research complete. Objective achieved.
Director, I will now explain to you the basic principles of the Logistics Management Center and Contract Exchange. At the top of the screen are the main categories of the Trade Exchange. Now select the Contracts category. You are now in the Contracts tab where you can see the available active. Now select the High Demand contract. This interface provides contract details. You can accept, cancel, or send resources from here, as well as track the status of the gear you will assign resources to be sent to complete the contracts. On the left side of the screen, there is a table of resources available at your base, and in the center, you have the dispatch window. On the right side, you'll find it.
As I thought, the coordinates were only approximate. For such cases, Rover is equipped with the LPS, Lunar Proximity Scanner. The Lunar Proximity Scanner, LPS, emits a focused beam of electromagnetic waves that when a hidden object is...
Good
job, Director. The funds should have been deposited into our account by now. With the successful execution of these contracts, we are well on our way to surpassing our expectations and fully covering the costs of our lunar expedition.
Desire to help or gain profit in exchange for resources is understandable. Their wealth
investing.
If you've ever if we direct.
Thank you.
Objective achieved. The coordinates were only approximate. For such cases, Rover is equipped with...
Attention! This is Cap...
We have located the cargo terminal.
Objective achieved.
Yes, Director. I do see them in the system as accepted.
My role is to secure that we can either...
Director, we'll deal with him later. Right now, let's concentrate on the...
Thank you.
has given us an additional set of drones which will allow us to expand production even further. Treat them with caution. They are a rare and extremely valuable resource right now.
Thank you.
Director, in order to reach the impact site, we require the... James is always calm and rational, even when he's winning big or losing his last buck. The next facility is the Engineering Center. It's run by Sullivan Eldower, local legend. Been on the moon even before Wilfrey and me. Old school, straight as an arrow, so not everyone can deal with him.